are going to have a tutorial for how to build a lantern to go on the new garage. We are going to use the Follow Me tool, which we haven't covered yet in any of the online tutorials. I'm a little out of order here, but not to worry, it's not a difficult one. What we're going to do is, right now, we have basically half of the silhouette, and then we have of the lantern, and then we have this hexagon shape, and we're going to rotate this silhouette to form the geometry of the lantern. And I'll show you how we're going to do that. So the first thing we're going to do is make this hexagon shape, right? So we are going to go over here to Polygon and click once, pull it out, and yes, indeed, this has six faces. If it doesn't, just hit the number six, all right, and we want it on, there we go, we want it like that. So it doesn't really matter how big it is, it just matters that it's a hexagon. And I do want the flat side towards the back, because that's where we're going to have the bracket that holds it onto the wall. All right, so the next thing I want to do is I'm going to create a rectangle, and it's going to be straight up and down, so as if it were a piece of paper. And what we're going to do is, let me do that right now, we're going to make this upright, and it's not snapping. Let me try this a different way. I want to go up. Oh, let's say I'm going to go up 2 feet. 2 feet. And nope, it's not going to let me do it. Oh, it's going to want to snap to that because it's getting it in first. And I'm going to pull it out however much. All right, so there's my rectangle. All right, now on this rectangle, I'm going to draw this shape, and then I'm going to cut out what I don't want. So it doesn't have to be exact. I'm going to go into a front view, and I'm going to turn off. There we go. So now it's flat. All right, so this line here is the center of the lantern. So let's start drawing. Get a little bit of a guideline here. All right, so let's say I have, I'm going to do an arc for this bottom part, and it's going to go to here, and it's going to be that big. I'm going to do a line, come in a little bit, come up, come in, up. Let's say we're going to go out, maybe up on a little bit of an angle. Good enough. Oops, didn't take it. Hold on, come on. There we go. And out. So this is the underneath side of the lantern. I'm going to come in. This part here is the glass. And then come out, the same, up. This is kind of the roof. And then, well, let's make it a little bit thinner. I'm going to go up, and I'm going to change this. I want a kind of a ball on top. So we're going to do from here to here. Do I want that? No, I don't want that. I want it kind of an arc. Let me do a line from here to there, and then we're going to do an arc from here to here, and we're going to pull it outwards. Yeah, so it's a little different. So now I'm going to select this piece, hit delete, and I'm also going to delete these edges because I don't need them anymore. So after that, I have my funky shape here, and I have my path, except there. Okay. Now, I'm going to select on my hexagon, and that's going to be the path that I rotate my lantern on, if that makes any sense. So we're going to say, select the path, click on follow me, and click on your shape. And it makes the shape for you. All right, so that's a big, hefty lantern. That's actually kind of fat. I don't think I want him that fat. Hit Control Z, and now we're going to, let's modify these guys. So I want, I want these, and I'm holding down the control button. Oops, didn't want that one. Did want that one. Now we're going to hold down control and shift. Now it minuses, it'll unselect. Now we're going to move inwards. Oh, dang it. I didn't want to do that. Let's minus that guy. Okay. Now we're going to move. We're going to bring him in just a little bit. Okay. And I got something weird going on right here. So let's just delete that. Okay. Now, I think I like that a little bit better. So actually, I'm going to move this one too. I don't think, I shouldn't have done that with the guideline. Let's move this guy in, because that's really too thick. Okay, good enough. All right, now let's do the follow me tool again. Except, delete that. Okay, so select your path, and then click on follow me, click on your shape, and that looks a whole lot better. Okay, now that I've got my shape, I want to do some things where the glass is going to be here. So I'm going to select one of these faces. I'm going to go to my, offset, and I'm going to bring this in, 3/8 of an inch. All right, now, fun part, come over here and double click. I'm supposed to be able to double click, and I got this to work. So if I go here and double click, it'll remember that I wanted 3/8 of an inch. So this makes things really fast. All right. So now we have a little edge of metal. Now we can select and do the push-pull. So let's see. Let's push-pull inwards. Not an inch. That's too much. Let's go inwards a half an inch. No, 3/8. All right. Also, double click, and it will repeat the offset. Okay, so now we have this cool looking lantern shape. All right, now I do want to build a bracket for it in the back, so where it's going to hook onto the wall. So come around here, and I want it centered here and here. So there's going to be two pieces of metal sticking out to attach it to the wall. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to find my center point. So I'm going to draw a line for my center point. All right, now that I've got that center point, I'm going to bring a guideline outwards, let's say a half an inch on either side, and then I'm going to delete this line because I don't need it anymore. What I am going to do next is draw a line here and here. Do the same thing down here. Okay. Then I can get rid of these guys. I don't need them. I'm going to select this face. I'm going to push pull. I'm going to bring it out. Oh, I don't know. Let's say 6 inches. All right. And double click. And it'll just repeat your last distance. Okay. So 6 inches is too much. All right. So that was a bad move. So instead, let's fix this. So we're going to select these guys and we're going to move them. And there we go. Select and move. green axis. You see that green dashed line? It says on green axis. And let's say 3 inches, because we don't want it sticking out that far. That's much better. Okay, so 3 inches away from the wall. Cool. Now, I am going to triple click and right click and say make a component. I'm going to call this thing lamp. Okay, fine. Now, it's a component. What I want to build next is the plate that is going to attach to the wall. So it's going to be kind of a rectangular plate here. So, let's see. I want to, probably the easiest thing to do is just build it flat and move it into straight, into position, I suppose. Eh. Or I could just build it in place. Let's try that. So if we say rectangle from here to here, and then we grab this edge, let's move it on the red axis, let's say 3 inches. And then select this side, move on the red axis, 3 inches. Okay, let's move, take this guy, top edge, move him upwards on the blue axis, 2 inches? Yeah. And then the bottom one, move downwards on the blue axis, 2 inches. Okay, so now what I have is where this thing is going to touch its little bracket. So we want to extrude this out, so push-pull, and let's make him be 2 inches thick, all right? Because I'm going to carve out some fancy molding around the edge here. This is too boring. Okay, we need a nicer lantern. So I am going to, on this edge, Let's get some guidelines just to be on the safe side. So let's come in, let's do a half inch, so 0.5 inches. And then we're going to come down. There we go. All right, so we're going to carve out kind of a beveling effect here. So we are going to say line, like that. Now, let's have something fancy going on here. So let's do an arc. Do I want to do an arc? Yeah, sure, let's do an arc. But I want to have a start and a stop point. And I'm going to come over an eighth and come down. Come on, give me an eighth. No, I want a sixteenth. There it is. I want an eighth. Okay, so this tells me here and here is where my arc is going to go. So I'm going to get my two-point arc. Start there, end there, and it's going to be, now I want to do this, the hard part is getting this on the face. I want it on the face. I want it that big. There we go. Now we got a half circle. Okay, so it's not sticking out in midair anywhere. It's on that face. So next, I'm going to erase this. All right. So this shape here is what I'm going to carve out all the way around the front edge. So what we're going to do, select that front face because that's the one we're going to carve out, and we're going to say, follow me, and then we're going to click here, and there it is. Ta-ta-da! Now we have this big fancy thing. However, look at all these polygons. That's way too many polygons. So Control Z. And we're going to go back in here, and we're going to fix that arc. I should have paid more attention to this arc. So we're going to do that, and we're going to come over here to our entity info. This thing has 12 segments. I don't need 12 segments. Let's make it be 6. And I'm thinking I'm going to make my radius a little bit smaller. Let's see what happens if I say 0.25 inches. Yeah, that's a little bit better. Is that better? Yeah. Maybe I don't want 3/8. Yeah, it's a little softer. It's good enough. We'll try that. Okay. So now We're going to go back, select the front face again, say, follow me, click on our shape. Yeah, that's better. Okay, I like that better. That's a little prettier. All right, now, if you notice that you can see all these weird dashed lines all over the place, and they're really getting in the way, first of all, let me get rid of my guides. Okay, second of all, we're going to go to View, and it says Hidden Geometry right here. So uncheck Hidden Geometry now. Whew, a lot less lines that you have to look at. Okay, so now that I've got this thing, I'm going to triple click, right click, make him a component, and call him base or something. Okay, now I want to put some materials on here. So I'm going to go to metal. Where's metal? Metal. And let's do silver? Sure, let's do silver. So if I put a material on this component, it goes to everything. Now, if I do that here, it's also going to go to everything, including the glass. So I don't want my glass to be metal. I want it to be glass. So we're going to double click to open up my component. Then I'm going to say B for bucket. I'm going to go over here to wherever it was, glass and mirrors. And this one, translucent glass with a sky reflection. That's nice. So let's put that on the glass. And we got one more in the back. And there we go. Okay. Now we're done. So before I do anything else, I'm going to get rid of this because I don't need it. And I'm going to grab these two components. I'm going to right click and I'm going to make them a group. And I'm going to call them Garage Lantern or whatever you prefer. Okay, now please notice that this thing is centered at the point of origin. So when I bring this in to my garage, when I import it into my garage, that's where he's going to want to come in. All right. So I am also going to, let's say, I'm going to do a save as real quick. We're going to call this Lantern 02. Okay. Now I'm going to take these, delete them. Now the only thing I have, hang on a second, that's my finished one. And we're going to delete him too, because I did that before. Okay, so the only thing I have in this whole file is just this lantern. That's all that's there. All right, now we're going to do a file save. And the next thing we're going to do is bring this in as an import into our garage file. Okay, there we go.